Fedora users. We are going to talk a little bit about something that probably could help you guys out a little bit. And it's something I rarely see people talk about. And it's a DNF plugin or tool, a way of upgrading your system, is that you don't have to use DNF upgrade, you know, sudo DNF upgrade or sudo DNF update and update everything. There's actually a way where you can only get security bug fixes, security fixes, and I think some enhancement. We look at what it gives you by a command called DNF up-min or DNF upgrade-minimum. Let's look into it, because this could help you guys and girls out there if you don't want, you know, the massive wall of update that comes with Fedora quite a lot, but you only want the important updates, the ones that actually really matters. And also then will therefore keep your system somewhat more stable to some extent and less evolving. You know, you're staying to, you look at it like you're doing a LTS update instead of you just doing, you know, your normal update. So let's look into it here. And this is from the Fedora, read the docs from Fedora's own DNF page here. Upgrade minimal command, DNF option upgrade minimal. If you just do upgrade minimum or DNF up min, as they have up here, update each package to the latest available version that provides a bug fix, enhancement, or fix for a security issue. So if there is a package in here that has a security issue, or there's an enhancement to the software or bug fix, you're only getting it. You're not getting a new piece of software just because there is a new color scheme, or there is, you know, they fixed like a button, you know, like this button here, or this little icon up here needs to be moved 2 pixels to the right. So that's where you will be running this upgrade the minimal command here. So let's take a little bit of a look in practice about how that looks on Fedora. So here I did a sudo DNF upgrade. This is the one that you would probably be running all the time. And you can see here that we have glibc, mesa, pipewire, sssssd. We have webkits, wireplum, and stuff like that. In total, we have 51 packages that needs to be upgraded at a size of 82 megabytes downloaded. If you do the DNF min, we have GNUP, we have mesa, pipewire, and webkit. So we don't have the glibc. The glibc is not there. The hardware data, HW data, is not there. Here, you're only upgrading things that provide a bug fix, enhancement, or security issue. So we're only upgrading 50% or actually less than 50% of the packages. So in a sudo DNF upgrade, we could debate that you're getting over 50% meaningless updates. I know, not again, when I say meaningless, don't take it as like literally, but you're getting, you know, upgrades that you probably, it's not necessary that you're doing. They can wait. You know, it's not necessary updates. So you're getting 52 packages that you really don't need to upgrade. You can wait with upgrading them. It's not unnecessary. It's not like, oh my God, I have to upgrade this or else I would have a security problem or a bug problem or anything like that. 52 packages really don't need to be upgraded. And that's why you should be running update min, in my opinion, more than you should be doing sudo DNF upgrade. Because with update min or up min, you are seeing what really needs to be upgraded. Like, this is a really necessity. And that's these 24 packages here. So my philosophy, I will give you like how you should look at this. Fedora gives you security and bug fixes to updates. So it's really, if you want to be as secure and as bug free as possible, you kind of have to upgrade all the time. Let's be honest here. If you really, really want the best possible outcome for your system, every time there's an update, you kind of have to do it. But you have to do the up min, because these are the important ones. Don't do a sudo apt or sudo DNF upgrade. Do a sudo DNF up dash min. Do that once a day, because these are the really important ones. Do that once a day. And then in my, this is how I would be, if I was maining Fedora, I would do a full-blown system update every 1 week, every 2 week maybe. You know, have like the big update once a week. And then once a day, I would be running this sudo dnf up mint to make sure that I have the latest security fixes, the latest bug fixes. And if there is a small enhancement that needs to be done for Maze or something like that. How you can also look at this. Let's say you get into a state, like you really, really like this state of Fedora right now. So if you go into about the system, I think they just got, not long ago, they got 5.22 of Plasma. If this is really working for you, this state of Fedora, the state it's in right now, is massively stable for you. It's just working there, that, you know, it's just fucking works. You could be running, or you could be doing DNF up min, because you're only getting bug fixes, enhancement, and security fixes. Meaning that you are, to some extent, running Fedora a little bit like LTS, Ubuntu LTS. You're finding a state that Fedora is massively great in. I really like the state Fedora's in right now. Then you could just do sudo up min to get the minimum required updates. Not looking for new features, you know, and stuff like that. And then you can run this for month, 2-3 months, and then you do a full-blown update. So it could be used in two ways, in many ways, but these are the two main ways I would be looking, or I would be using it if I was me. Upgrade every day with upmin, every Sunday with upgrade, you know, do a full-blown upgrade. And if I hear people have problems with the latest upgrade with Fedora, you know, the latest Plasma version is just acting fucking out, you know, the latest KDE desktop or the latest version of VLC or Firefox or Chrome or whatever is being a fucking douchebag, I'll be like, you know what? I like how Fedora is right now. So until I hear that those problems are being ironed out, I'm only doing a upmin upgrade. Because I know Fedora is working right now. I hear a lot of people having problems with latest upgrades. It don't happen much anymore, but it could be happening. So just to be sure, I will keep just basically keeping the existing software that I have on my system. Basically freezing the software versions even more on my current install. So it's a really important tool that can be used to make sure that your system is as stable as it possibly can be. So yeah, like really, really take this into considerations when you're running Fedora. Know it's out there, know it's a possibility, and really, really evaluate, does it make sense for me to not just get an update for the sake of upgrade, but getting upgrades that's really important. See you all later. Bye-bye.